Hey y'all, welcome back to my channel. And if you're new here, welcome to my channel. It's Zayna, and make sure you subscribe because it's a vibe each and every time. Anyways, so y'all, today I'm so excited. It's currently Saturday. I don't know what date. Okay, it's currently Saturday, January 13th, 9:45 a.m. I almost said p.m. And we're up and we're at them, okay? Well, today we're going on a solo date. We're going to be romanticizing our day in Brooklyn. Because literally, I'm just a black girl in Brooklyn. Literally, just a black girl in Brooklyn. So we're going on a solo date today because I haven't done one of these since, I think, my last solo date video. If you guys haven't seen that, go watch that. So I think this is episode 3 in this series, and period. Give you guys like the rundown of like my day, how it's gonna go, outfit details, all that jazz after my shower. So yeah, you guys will see me in like a jiff. Okay y'all, so we're out the shower. I look very much dry because I did not moisturize my face, but we're out the shower. It's currently 10:10, and let's just go through what we're gonna do today, because I don't even think I told y'all. So first, well, I don't know which one I want to do first. It depends on what time I leave the crib. So first and foremost, I'm going to go to a cafe called Love Lane BK. It's a black owned cafe in Brooklyn. And I don't know if it's woman owned. I think so, but I'm not 100% sure with that one. But I know it's black owned. And I seen a little bit of post about it on TikTok and Instagram. And it seems really cute. It got that like Brooklyn hype artist type of vibe. I don't really know how to describe it, but I definitely want to go there and get like a small bite, because I'm on a diet. So either a small bite, I know they have strawberry matcha, I think I want to try that. So I'm gonna go to that cafe or coffee shop or whatever. And then I got tickets yesterday, obviously, for today, to go see the Spike Lee exhibit. And if you don't know, Spike Lee has an exhibit at the Brooklyn Museum, and it's just like, I'm from Brooklyn, of course I'm gonna go see the Spike Lee Museum. I remember he used to throw, like, I think he still does, but he used to throw block parties all the time in like Bed-Stuy, and me and my friend Mia would always go with our moms like every single year. I dead met him too at one of the block parties, and he said, oh no, it was Michael Jackson's birthday that he threw like block parties every year, and he dead signed my Michael Jackson shirt and all that. And he came to my school because we did like a little, like, not TED talk, but like a little talk, a little event with Spike Lee. And I don't think I met him, but you know, he was passing by. I was like, oh my god, Spike Lee, you're from Brooklyn, I'm from Brooklyn, period. So yeah, of course I'm gonna go see the exhibit. So yeah, that's what I'm gonna do. And then since I'm in the area, and I'm literally in the area of my, like, I'm about to be going back as if I'm going to work, but whatever. There's a bookstore called The Ripped Bodice. If y'all don't know, it's like a romance, strictly romance bookstore. My friend Kayla, she's also on YouTube, so go check out her channel, Kayla Anik, period. She went there in one of her vlogs, and it looked really cool inside. But I don't know if I'm really like a romance type of girl, for real. I fake am, because my favorite book is Before I Let Go by Kennedy Ryan. Like, if you haven't read that book, you need to go read it. It's amazing. Like, I love that book. So I feel like I could probably go in there. But if not, there's another bookstore down there, or like downtown, called like Greenlight Bookstore or something like that. I don't know, one of them, Green something. I was gonna go there because it's obviously not dedicated strictly to romance books. I can find other books that I have on my list at that bookstore rather than The Ripped Bodice. So, and they're both in opposite directions, so I have to make up my mind on which one I'm gonna go to. I'm leaning more towards the Greenlight Bookstore though, because on the way there I could pass Whole Foods, and Whole Foods, if you don't know, like, you can make, like, pick out your flowers and then they'll make a bouquet for you. And I kind of want to get myself some flowers, or my mom some flowers. So I'm going to pass through Whole Foods, get that, and then I can go to Greenlight. And yeah, so that's my day. Basically, we're going to go to the coffee shop, we're going to go to the museum, we're going to go get some flowers, and we're going to go to the bookstore. And I just think that's a wholesome day. Yeah, that's the agenda for today. I'm really excited to go. The museum slot that I booked is, I think it booked the slot for 12. I should have did 12:30, but I think I booked the slot for 12. Let me check. Yo, I know myself so well. Okay, I booked it for 12:30. Okay, great. So I have a little bit more time, and then I can actually go to the cafe first and then go to the museum, because I was going to go to the museum then the cafe, because I didn't think I was going to have enough time. And I'm not driving, because around there is no parking, and I'm going to be walking all over and going to a different spot. So we're hopping on the bus. We're going on the bus or the train, because it's Saturday. We all know New York City public transportation is not your friend on the weekends, but I'm going to still duck it out and go, because Yeah. Let me show you guys my outfit though. So it's very much basic, but whatever. This is my shirt. It's from AliExpress, y'all. I got this for like $2.50 or something like that. Or $4.38. I don't know. It was less than $6 though. But it's just this white graphic tee with like these two girls. I don't know who these girls is, but I think it's a cool type of t-shirt. So, and are they smoking? Oh, I didn't even know that, but whatever. And then we have these jeans that are about to be like my favorite jeans ever from Bershka. There's just these cargo jeans that I got for $20. Okay, Bershka's having a sale, go check them out. But they're so fire, bro. Obviously you'll see it better when I put the outfit on, but yeah, these are so fire. And for $20, even more fire. More fire, more fire. Anyways, and then just to add some color to my outfit, I'ma wear this pink Spider-Man beanie. I got this also from AliExpress. Me and AliExpress, we go together real bad. Real bad. Cause this is one thing I'ma do. I'ma find it on AliExpress. Cause all these boutiques be getting these stuff wholesale from Alibaba and then hacking up the price times 5,000. Babe. I know your source. Come on. Don't play with me. Don't play with me. Cause I'm gonna screenshot the photo on your website or on your Instagram page and put it into AliExpress to see where you got it. And 8 times out of 10, it pops up. So, period. And then as for my shoes, I'm just gonna be basic and go with these off-white. What are these called again? Yeah, I don't know. But y'all seen these like time and time again. Probably years ago, because I know they were really popular years ago, but they're just these off-white sneakers. Nothing too crazy. I feel like low-key it might be a little thrown off because I'm wearing a pink hat, and I don't know, but I feel like these are neutral enough for me to wear with this outfit. So I'm gonna get ready and then I'm gonna show you guys the whole outfit when I'm fully like dressed, accessorized, and all that jazz. So yeah, cheers to the first solo day of 2024 and to many, many more. Yo, stop playing with me. Somebody get me in the studio, please. Hit me up if you have a studio time. Let's book. Let's work. Let's connect. Let's work. Let's work. Okay? All right. Period. But yeah, y'all. I'm about to go moisturize because my face is so dry. But it's soft. Period. And I'm about to get dressed, bump some music to get my vibes pumping for the day. And then I'm going to come back on here once I'm dressed. All right, y'all. So we know how when you plan to fit in your head and it don't, you put it on, it don't come out how it was supposed to. Yeah, so we had to make a couple of changes to the fit. But I'm going to try to show y'all at my best of ability. My room is messy because I was trying to figure out what goes with what. But anyways, hat, AliExpress, these glasses I put on. They're like blue light glasses, but whatever. They're like this green, I don't know, material. It's cute. Amazon, AliExpress. This is my puffer that I got years ago from Forever 21, and I'm burning up. This bag is from Urban Outfitters. My jeans is from Bershka. And I realized that, like, my off-whites, this will be my second time ever wearing them, and they're just not comfortable enough to be walking around in all day. So I just put on my Margiela replicas because these are really, really comfortable. Just these ones. They're really, really comfortable. So yeah, that's my fit. I will show y'all in my mirror, but I just have a whole bunch of clothes and stuff in the background. So when I get home, I'm gonna clean my room and then I'm gonna come back and like show y'all the full fit. But she's cute. 10:55 and I'm starving, so I'm about to head out and go to the cafe right now. I wish I had a little snack or something to eat, but I think I can make it because I feel like it's gonna take me 40 minutes to get there, and it's like 20 minutes from the museum, so I think I'd be in good timing if I leave right now, grab something quick, and go to the museum for 12:30. So I don't know if I'm gonna talk to you guys when I'm outside because, you know, social anxiety, minor social anxiety, but hopefully, ooh, something's in my eye. Anyways, hopefully we'll be able to get some b-roll. There's okay, I'm a mess right now. I'm gonna get b-roll for y'all know that. And yeah, so actually, should I go without the glasses? I think that the glasses add a nice touch. We'll see. But yeah, I will see you guys whenever I see y'all. Let's go let's go romanticize our day in Brooklyn on this solo day. What the?
rock you. Can we talk about us like we care about us? Can we talk about us like we care about us? You say, let it free, but the pain of our heart can't let it be. We both can agree. Tell me what is
hey, y'all, it's pretty dark and I'm not finna hold the camera up, but I just left the museum and I'm walking to Love Lane, the little coffee shop place, to get something to eat. And oh nah, I could have took the train, but I was like, let me just take a walk. It's not cold, it's not hot, like it's just right for walking. So oh, I can hold it. I'm just nervous. So yeah, I'm just gonna walk. And my phone is gonna die. I hope that they have places to charge it. I'm not 100% sure. But yeah, after, I'll probably see you guys when I get there. Cause yeah, I hope there's seating, cause it's a small little cafe and it's like 2 o'clock right now. So people might be outside. So fingers crossed that I can get a seat.
Not the first, like the cool bitch.
So I'm back home. I've been home for like an hour, give or take. I was making a TikTok of my outfit, so be sure to go follow me on TikTok. But yeah, I'm home and I just wanted to come on here and do a recap of my day. So let's get into it. I think I'm gonna sit down and talk to y'all because yeah. Okay y'all, so today was literally like so nice. Well, it was a little hiccup, I'm gonna get into it, but today was really 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 nice. I really enjoyed myself. So I guess we can do like a timeline. Even though y'all saw it, I'm gonna still talk about it. So as you know, we went to the Spike Lee exhibit. I told y'all that I was gonna go to the cafe first and then the exhibit, but I was like, I seen that they have French toast in the menu and I've been obsessed with French toast. So by the time I was gonna get to the cafe, I wouldn't have enough time to sit and enjoy it. So I was like, I'm gonna just go to the museum and then I'll just go to the cafe after so I can actually sit and enjoy the French toast. So because I didn't eat anything all day, I just stopped at like a nearby little shop just to get something in my body. And I'm also trying to get back into intermittent fasting. So I was like, it's just perfect if I just have me a little smoothie for the morning. And by that time it was like 12 o'clock and that's like the perfect time to start, that I start eating for the day. I forgot what it's called. I think it's like the Jungle Juice Cafe. And the smoothie was really really good. It's just that the thing about eating healthier, it's just so expensive because that smoothie cost me $8. Like, so I need to start making, like, buying frozen fruits and all those things. Just start buying fruits and all the different stuff that I want to put in my smoothie and make it myself, because I can't be spending $8 every single time. I bought one the other day for before work, it was another $8. Like, I really cannot be doing it. So yeah, that was really really good. Then I just walked over to the museum and the exhibit was amazing. Like, oh my god, like, first of all, I love the fact that I went by myself so I can like sit and enjoy the art and like the exhibit as long as I want. I think I spent an hour and change walking through the whole museum. The way it was structured was really nice. It had like sections, so like 1 through 6 or 7, and each section was like a different theme. So it was like photography, music, cinema, family, the Knicks, of course, because we know Spike Lee and the Knicks go together real bad. Yeah, it was just a whole exhibit just full of black art. And one thing I realized, I'm like, wait, is all of this art like in Spike Lee's crib or what? Because that, it was a lot of art and just, it was just amazing. Like, he's really that guy. And I don't know if I told y'all that he had came to my school. I think I did. But yeah, he's just really that guy. And I just really have been discovering my passion for like black art, black, not, I've always had a passion for black culture. Like,
I've been, you know what I'm saying? But trying to like learn more and find out new things has just really been my thing these past couple of years, and this exhibit really did it for me. And just, oh my god, I can't even begin to tell y'all the amount of stuff that was in that exhibit. It was so rich and like enlightening. It had a lot of history aspects, like the 16th Street church bombing, the bus boycotts, the riots from Black Lives Matter, the sit-ins that I forget what it's called, but when they sat in the did the like the diner sit-in, I forgot the name of it, it's a prominent protest that happened, a lot of Dr. King stuff, and it was just amazing. So I'm gonna just kind of like scroll through my gallery just so I can like highlight a couple of things that I took pictures of. He had a lot of not a lot, but a good amount of stuff from like Nelson Mandela. Like he had an original signed flag from Nelson Mandela. He had stuff from Angela Davis, like her posters of like wanted posters and stuff like that. What else? A lot of MLK stuff, like a lot. He even had a couple of these things, if you know about like Black history and stuff like that, you know about blackface and oh my god, what is that movie, that the depiction of blackface, like the first movie where they had like a white man in blackface? Yo, like I know what it is. Oh my god. Oh my, the birth of a nation, I think it's called that. They had, he had like little arts, I'm gonna put it on the screen, but he had like little art pieces from that. Even the thing with like the watermelon stereotype with like Black people and watermelon. And did y'all know that I'm about to go into a little Black history, because I just love that. I love Black history. And even before I even go in that, one thing, a concept I would never ever 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 till the day I die and even in the afterlife would ever understand is racism. Because if you really boil down to it and if you really look at it, how are you mad at me because of my skin color? How you mad at me because generations ago your ancestors went and picked people up from their home and their habitat and brought and put them on a slave with millions of other people and tiny, like had them living in their feces, whipped them? Like how are you mad at something that y'all did to like us? I just would never understand racism. I would never ever understand it. I'm sorry, I'm just never understanding that. I'm never understanding that concept. I'm never ever gonna understand it. Like it just does not make sense. Like how are you mad at me because of my skin color? How are you mad? Like what? Like we could even, like when I was in this exhibit, I'm like, I was just thinking about a whole bunch of like Black History Month type of videos that I'm thinking of doing for YouTube. So stay tuned for that. So we're gonna definitely go into that more in those videos. So yeah, let me just get back to the exhibit, because if it's one thing about me, I'm gonna talk about Black people. Okay, my major in college, social work, political science, that was my realm, advocacy, policy. And we had this one class called Black Rage and White Fragility. Best class ever. And best believe I was in there every day or every week talking, bro. Trust, the most participation I probably ever did in a class in my 12 years of grade school and 4 years of college, because I just love those things. But yeah, we're going on a whole tangent. But and I say did y'all know that the original ice cream song was it's like You're One of Watermelon or something like that? Yeah, crazy, right? Learn your history. Anyways, and it was just a whole bunch of like Black art going through the times, police brutality, all the movies that he's done. And did y'all know he has a film studio called 40 Acres and a Mule? That's his like recording film studio, whatever. He had a couple pieces from Toni Morrison, and if you know Toni Morrison, you know how great of an author she is. This art was really nice too. It's a collage of Trayvon Martin, and I was just like, wow. And also, I'm sorry, I'm going to do a lot of talking because this exhibit was amazing. But when I was in the museum, it was a lot of people. And I found it kind of really, I'm like, okay, allyship. Then he had like, well, I keep saying like, and I hate when people say like, so I'm going to stop. He had a section on family. And his dad was like the renowned jazz player, Bobby Lee. If you know, you know. And his mother and his grandmother went to Spelman, and he went to Morehouse. And I know when he came and talked to like did a talk at my school, he was saying how his grandmother paid for his education at Morehouse and NYU Film School. So that was really nice. And they're all HBCU grads, so period. Of course he had a section about Brooklyn, because how, like, you, Spike, what is Spike Lee without Brooklyn? Absolutely nothing. And what is Brooklyn without Spike Lee? Absolutely nothing. So that was my, I keep saying like, That was probably my favorite section, because why not? And this one was a really cool piece of art. And if you know me, like, I love sneakers. I love Jordan. So that was a really cool piece of art. This is another piece of art that I really liked. It was of George Floyd. I don't know if it's in focus, but I'll put it on the screen as well. That one was really cool. This is also another thing that I really liked. If you know Absolute Vodka, then you know. It's called Absolute Brooklyn. And I just love it because I love being from Brooklyn. Because Brooklyn, period. Like, he also had some Biggie art, which is really cool. A lot of Michael Jackson art. He had a Knicks section. And then there was this quote on the wall that says, "There's something about Brooklyn. It's the people, the diversity, the culture, the people who make up this great borough. I mean, I grew up here and it's developed the person who I am and who I've become. And so therefore, that has been in the subject of a lot of my films." Because period. One thing I would say, though, even like walking before and after the museum throughout Brooklyn, because, you know, I'm trying to like romanticize the best borough ever. It's so crazy how gentrified it is. Like, it's so crazy. And I've been new about gentrification, especially because Brooklyn was probably one of the first places to get gentrified, especially around that area. So it's just so crazy. And I think having this exhibit is really nice to hone in on the culture and the history and the roots of Bed-Stuy, Crown Heights, and that area. And even walking through the neighborhood, still seeing some like mom and pop shops and black owned businesses was really nice to see, despite the gentrifiers coming in and taking over extremely. So yeah, that's also why I wanted to go to Love Lane, because it's a black owned cafe, and I think female owned too. So black female owned cafe, but we're gonna get into that. But all this to say, the exhibit was amazing. It was just overall really, really cool. And there were actual, like, his books of, I guess these were notes or scripts or screenwrites of his movies. And I think that was probably one of the coolest things ever. So, for example, this book, Original, Do the Right Thing by Spike Lee, first draft, started March in 1988, Brooklyn, New York, finished March 16th, 1988. You wrote that in 15 days, Spike? You're goated. And also, this has inspired me because I haven't seen all of the Spike Lee films, and I haven't watched, I think, School Days and whatever, Crooklyn in a really long time. So I'm gonna like have a whole Spike Lee movie night when I'm done talking to y'all, because I just think that's the perfect way to end the night. And if not tonight, then some other night. But I'm really gonna tap into my black history in terms of visual arts in films and watching all the OG movies, all the classics that every black person should watch, and also things like the Black Klansman and all those historical black history type of movies, TV shows, anything. I'm about to tap into books because it's just like I want to be knowledgeable of any and everything related to black people, because that's just who I am. I'm pro-black, okay? So yeah, this just really sparked my interest in all things like this. Yeah, but yeah, we're gonna get into that. And also, the people that were in the exhibit were just really nice. So I'm like, yo, these are my type of people. I need creative friends. I need friends that like art and just cool things like this, that like black history, that can sit down with me and have a conversation about black people. Not to say that like I wouldn't do that with my friends, but I just feel like obviously we don't have it to the same capacity, but I feel like I need somebody that is like just like me, you know what I'm saying? But it's okay, at least I know enough that I can enjoy these things by myself. I don't need other people to enjoy these things. It would be nice to have a companion that, you know, has similar interests to the same realm as me, but totally fine. His little gift shop was called the Crooklyn Bodega. I was gonna get a shirt, but it's also like I don't want people to see that and be like, oh, she crip. Like, no, bro, it's Spike Lee stuff. So I don't know, I'm thinking about it. I can always order it online. So yeah. And then after the exhibit, obviously I kept saying I went to Love Lane BK. I had the creme brulee French toast. It was amazing. Like, she was doing her thing. She literally stood there and torched the sugar on all four of my French toast. Like, she really took her time with it. And then I had a strawberry matcha that was also really good. Oh my god, I like, that's my new favorite place. It's really small and an intimate place, but if you get there early, you can get your seat. Yeah, that one was really, really nice. A really nice cafe. I can definitely see myself going there and again, and the French toast was so good. I forget, there's this, it was a Caribbean spice on the French toast and I just couldn't put my finger on it, but I know it. But yeah, overall really, really good. And then here's where we So I told y'all I was gonna go to Greenlight Bookstore, right? So I was gonna walk, but from the cafe to the bookstore was a 35-minute walk. So I was like, that's kind of a drag. The train is right there. Let me just hop on the train. Swipe into the train. Cool. I'm waiting for the train, and then I see only like the A is coming out. I need the C. So I was like, okay, fine. Then I realized that the C was downstairs. So I go downstairs. As I'm going down the stairs, the train pulls off. Cool. Next one's 11 minutes, right? Now I'm like, it's me and one other man on the platform, and he's doing some sketchy stuff. So I'm like, yo, please, come on, come on. So I stay by the steps just in case, you know, I had to run upstairs real quick. Then I'm looking at the sign, bro, and it says Euclid, and I know that's Brooklyn, bro. But I'm like, I need to be going further into Brooklyn. And I'm like towards like Manhattan side. So I'm like, is this the right place? It gotta be, because I didn't see where else to get the C upstairs. It was only the A. So I get on the train. Guys on the train, you know how Brooklyn be, talking his shit out loud, crazy, talking about people gonna die, people gonna go to hell. Cool. I'm looking at the stops and I'm not seeing Lafayette. It's going deep into Brooklyn. I'm talking Broadway Junction. I don't need to be on nobody's Broadway Junction right now, for me. So I'm dumb tight. I get off the next stop. I'm like, damn. And then it's one of those stations where I can't just like go up and go down to the Manhattan side. So I'm like, I'm gonna have to come out all together. So I come out. I see the bus. I search up. I could take the bus there. Cool. It's gonna be 23 minutes. Fine. I could use my transfer. All right, cool. I get on the bus and I'm like, is this the right one? Is this the right direction? All I see was Flushing and I just hopped on. So I'm on the bus. I'm using my maps. I get on the bus. It says 12 stops. Cool. So I don't really know the area, so I'm tracking it on the maps. I refresh my location on the maps and then it says 13 stops. I'm like, that's funny. Why is the number going up when it should be going down? Am I on the wrong, I'm on the wrong side? Refresh again, 14 stops away. Now I'm like, okay, let me look at the map list and see the stops. Come to find out, I'm on the wrong bus. So I said, oh, hop off the bus. Now I'm in the middle of I don't know where. And I'm like, yo, is this a sign? Should I just go home? Like, what's tea? All right, cool. I was going to take the bus. It was going to be a 30-minute ride back to the bookstore. So I'm like, nah, let me just take the train. The train say 12 minutes. Cool. Looking for the train. Finally find the train. As I'm going down the stairs, what's leaving? The train. Had to wait 15 minutes for the next one. Cool. Finally get on the train. I'm like checking before I even step in to see if that's the right one. It was. Finally, I made it. But me getting lost in my own borough, because Brooklyn is so big. Like, I'm trying to sit here and romanticize me and my whole day. And ain't nothing romantic about getting lost in freaking Crown Heights, bro. Absolutely nothing, okay? But, I finally made it to the bookstore. I went in the bookstore. It was a lot of people. And, honestly, I could order these books off Amazon because they're much cheaper. But I'm like, I just spent, like, 45 minutes trying to get here when it should have been 12. I'm leaving here with something. So I just kept searching all these books up on Amazon to see which one was the most, like, the closest in price is if I were to get it here. And they all were on sale on Amazon, but I'm like, I don't care, I'm leaving here with something. End up getting this book, The Vanishing Half, because I searched it up on TikTok and it had really, really, really great reviews. Everybody was loving it. Somebody said, like a couple people said, this is the book that actually got me back into reading. And if it's one thing about me, I need to read my books, because I got two books for Christmas and then I just bought another one like a week or two ago. And then I have probably like, I want to say 20 books in my little shelf that I haven't even read. I read probably two books out of those 20. And then I just bought two today. So it's just like, I need this one book to really get me back into reading, because I have so many books to read. And I think that's gonna be good for me, because I'm trying to not use my phone before I go to bed, because there's no reason why I'm trying to fall asleep and I can't fall asleep until 3 a.m. So I think instead of on my phone at night, it's gonna give a book at nighttime. Then I got this one because I think it's brand new and I didn't see it on Amazon yet. Or no, I did, but it was the same price as the bookstore. So I'm like, I'm gonna just get it. It's called Creative Struggle is Real, Stop Procrastinating and Start Making. This book. I kind of see, just show y'all. And I think that was a sign from God, because I seen it right when I was about to check out and I was going through it and it had like a whole bunch of prompts. It's kind of like a book and a journal in one in relation to creating content. And I feel like I need that because I really want to lock in on all platforms, YouTube, TikTok, even Instagram. Like, I'm really trying to lock in. So there's that. And then I walked over to Whole Foods because I told y'all Whole Foods makes bouquets, but the bouquet person wasn't there, obviously probably because it was later on at night. And they also didn't have good flower choices, which kind of sucked because every other time I went into Whole Foods, they had good flowers. So I just walked randomly. I'm like, maybe I find like a little store that sells flowers outside or something. And as I was walking, I seen flowers in the window. Went in, got me a little bouquet for I think $20. And the guy was gonna wrap for me and make it all pretty, but I was like, it's okay, I'm gonna take it out and put it in the vase when I get home. So yeah, I got my flowers. I think I showed y'all, or I will show y'all. And what better way to romanticize your day in Brooklyn than taking the dollar van home? Like, if you're from the city, especially in Brooklyn, then you know what a dollar van is. And yeah, I just took my dollar van home and now we're here. But yeah, that was me romanticizing my life and romanticizing my day in Brooklyn, solo day edition. And I just love being from Brooklyn. I make that my whole entire personality. Anytime somebody meets me and whatever, somewhere along the lines of the conversation, I say I'm from Brooklyn and I make that my whole personality. And I'm not ashamed of it. We really had a fun day today and cheers to more solo dates in 2024. This is your sign. Stop waiting for people and go out by yourself. Self-love is the best love. There's no reason why you should have to be, oh, I can't do this. Oh, I can't go here because I want to do it with this, that, and the person and nobody wants to do it with me, so I have to wait. No. Stop it. Go. By yourself, okay? Enjoy your own company. And I was literally radiating the whole day. I could take my time, I can look at this, I can look at that, I can walk here, I can go there, and nobody's in my ear. I don't have to sit down and make conversation. Like, it's just, what a time. If you guys enjoyed this video, and make sure you subscribe, because you can't sit here and tell me that you didn't enjoy this. Like, let's be real. Let's be real. It's the way you act. It's the way I act. Yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed this video and make sure you subscribe because it's a vibe each and every time. Like, come on, come on, come on, right? Okay, and I'll catch, why am I clapping? Like, I'm like about to cheer. Anyways, third time's a charm. Let's do that again, normally. I hope you guys enjoyed this video and make sure you subscribe because you can't just sit here and tell me that you wasn't vibing with me because we was vibing together, okay? Okay, twin? So yeah, make sure you subscribe and be sure to check me out in my next video. And if you haven't watched any of my other videos, go watch them so you can just see more of this face until the new upload comes. So yeah, I hope you guys enjoyed and have a good day or night or wherever time you're watching this. Bye!